All of you sit.
The leader of opposition, Mathias Simpoga, bounced today with a rebuttal to government statement on issues of gross human rights violations and enforced disappearances that informed the opposition boycott of plenary sittings. Mpoga presented detailed information to cement opposition claims on missing persons and questioned government's will to act.
Madam Speaker, this matter has nothing to do with the vote. It has got to everything to do with understanding the duty of the executive.
We have failed in this matter. We have failed to understand each other.
No, Madam Speaker,
I
challenge the Prime Minister to raise the microphone and say that government has failed to understand their duty in this matter, then the House will take a decision.
He tabled before Parliament a number of documentary evidence and video clips detailing particulars of the 18 alleged missing persons, which government is yet to declare their whereabouts.
The beauty about the dossiers I'm laying is that I am quoting each of them in my statement, so there will be no contradiction or problem in appreciating what they are. The video clips, at your pleasure, you look at them.
No problem. Thank you. Thank you. Yes.
Right, Honourable Speaker, you guided well
The opposition put for demands to Parliament, including the unconditional release of political prisoners, establishment of a judicial commission of inquiry, need for a select committee, and transfer of civilians under trial in the general court martial to civil courts.
All those persons not subjected to military law and are currently being tried before any military court be transferred to civil courts under the direction of the Director of Public Prosecution as directed by the Constitutional Court in Constitutional Petition Number 44 of 2015, retired Captain Amon Biarugaba and others versus the Attorney General.
However, during the debate on the matter, opposition's prayers faced resistance from government side with a number of excuses fronted by the right front bench which queried opposition claims of human rights violations.
He asked whether we feel pain and are alive, and if we feel for others and are human. I want to restate here that we are both and even more. We do, however, even have the obligation as government to protect and preserve human rights as enjoined by the Constitution of Uganda. Gave our all, which was sufficient, and in particular about the two identifiable ones. We even identified the driver of the police vehicle regarding the girl who died. There was no attempt at all to cover up. What better accountability can we give?
Prayers were made by neutralists for the matter to be handled in the non-partisan manner for the good of the said victims and their relatives. But still, lawmakers were inclined on political lines.
Don't want anybody to use this debate as a political spear to achieve a political purpose. But I don't want anybody also, in my view, to have a political shield. Because what eventually becomes a victim are the people of Uganda, who are vulnerable.
The matter was settled by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, calling for a meeting with the Uganda Human Rights Commission on allegations of rights abuses by security agencies, which will be attended by herself, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayebwa, and the Leader of Opposition, Mathias Simpoga.
So I want executive to go and examine these prisoners and cause release of these prisoners. Go and examine them. The prisoners who have been there beyond the mandatory time, who have not been tried, and we should have finished this issue.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.
That we have trust in the institutions.